Okay, cool. Welcome back. Harvest time. I'm just gonna start this dude off and I'll tell you what I've been up to. Right, you see, I've got a trailer load of logs. Because I've sort of cleared away a few of these trees here, so it's a bit of an easier run into the silo. You can't quite see the path here. I might even take a couple of these out too. You remember last time we did the baling of the grass? These are all lined up ready for when we can afford the silage wrapper. You've got my tedder and the baler ready there. Now I've got the loader wagon on the back of the tractor. Now that's ready for when this harvester's done his job here. Now what I'm going to do, instead of selling it or baling it, the straw at least, I'm just going to dump in here because I'd quite like to buy, quite like to save up for a hayloft, but they're $90,000. But I think that'd be really handy because we'd be able to dump in our hay and our straw and like drive a truck or a trailer or something next to it and fill it up so we don't just have to dump it on the ground or sell it, hey, like once we've got too much of it. But I'll wait for this dude to do most of this field then. Oh no, I should go over it with a windrower. That might make it easier, eh? Okay, so you will attach. We'll detach that. And we'll grab the windrower and we'll get ready for that once this dude's finished most of this field. Cause then, like rather, yeah, you saw last time when we did the grass, how much easier it was just to drive up like one stripe instead of like, you know, four or five, you know, to get a whole fill of it, you know. Oh, shit, I need to drop that. Okay, now we're hooked on. Just park this dude around here. Now, something else I did too was I sold like one trailer load worth of wood because I did a few other trees on the other side of the silo to make it a little bit easier too. I'll probably take those ones out on the side of the hay barn too. What else did I do? Oh yeah, I took this fuel trailer to get filled because that was just about empty. My tractor was just about empty too. And I've been watching the prices. Canola's going down. We've got a whole bunch of that on the train. Soy is like really low and we'll be harvesting that in a minute, but oh, bloody barley's going down too. So we might actually have to sit on our crops for a day or two, eh? Yeah, we'll see what happens. Yeah, we might have to do a job, I think. Let's see how this dude's doing. Oh, he didn't open the straw thing. You clown. That's what I get for not paying attention. There we go. Here we go. So that was bit of a bloody waste actually. That would have been what, three or two or three rows of that? Bugger, bugger. All right then, well I'm just gonna sit here and wait for this guy to finish this field, then I'll windrow it and I'll bring you back like, I don't know, when a bit more work's done, once I've got like a full loader wagon, so I can show you what I'm gonna do with the straw. So cool, we'll see you soon. Okay, cool, welcome back. I finally finished harvesting this field with the barley on it. Now I'm just going to move this dude out of the way for a second. Yeah, we'll get this guy. We'll set this guy up to start harvesting the other field and I'll tell you what I'm up to. I windrowed about half of this field myself and yeah, kind of got a bit goofy there. So I'm going to use the worker to do the other bit there, and you might do it a bit more evenly. I'll start this dude off. Alright, I'll get this guy to do. Oh yeah, he might sort of tidy this up a bit for us, eh? So. Okay, cool. Okay, we'll take the squad down to the train, because I noticed the price of barley hasn't really gone down too much, eh? Look, a few dollars per 1,000 litres. So, I think I'll just take the train and sell what barley we have, and that'll help us get through the next day, you know. Help us with wages, and maybe, you know, if we need to buy a trailer or something. I was thinking of buying a flatbed, but, probably won't need it yet. Oh, that dude's actually finished what he was up to, the wind drawing, so that's good. So we'll dump this off, we'll take the train over, we'll sell all our barley, because there's about 30 odd thousand of it or something on the train. Okay, now that dude can wait, eh? That dude can wait. That dude's at 7%. Okay, now we need to just change the option so we can swap to the trains easier. Switch the trains on, okay. This dude, yep. Give me all the barley. So 25,000 litres of it. So that'll give us enough to get through the next day or two, I think. Because remember, yeah, we'll still have to pay some wages to, sow the fields and maybe a few other little things too. So I'm hoping, yeah, I should. Luckily, I don't have to steer. Is it 780? Was it about 783 or something? I think it was. So I think we'll just sell the barley now. It's about as good a price as we'll get for it, though. It'll save us having to wait through the next lot pricing cycle, because it seems to go down and up and down and up, you know. It seems to undulate a little bit like that. So we'll sell what we've got. We'll sit on the canola, because I think the price for that's actually kind of rubbish at the moment. But we'll check that while we have the train here, though. Yeah, I think it. Yeah, I had the barley at the back. And the canola at the front. And we've still got some soy to harvest as well. I'll just move forward a bit so we can unload the right wagon. Okay, cool, yes, let's unload that one. Cool, so about 20 grand. Okay, we'll leave that dude from here. This dude's at 20%. Yeah, we'll take this dude back now. Because by the time we sort of finish goofing around, that harvester will be nearly full again. And it'll be a bit of a hassle having to wait. Eh? And, oh yeah, something else too. I've bred another sheep. So now instead of 12, we have 13. So that's kind of exciting. Took bloody ages, eh? Like, how many game days was that? Oh, heaps. Okay, yeah, we'll just leave this dude here, he'll be right. Oh, I think I'll just do this myself. It might be easier. They need to be lowered. See, yeah, it's a bit goofy when I do it myself. It's hard to get in a straight line, eh, sometimes. But that'll be right, we'll be able to pick most of the stuff up with the loading wagon. Yeah, bugger it, that'll do. Okay, we'll grab the loading wagon, and I'll just show you what I'm going to do with all the hay. Oh, not the hay, the straw. Getting a little bit ahead of myself. We don't actually have any hay yet, no. I don't want to unfold that. Just want to detach. I suppose, oh yeah, we could sell that wood. That'll be probably 5,000, or a few thousand of wood there. So once again, I've been, making sure I get bigger logs, eh? And they seem to go for more money, eh? Which is cool. do this bugger out up here. Lower it between one. So we should get a full wagon by the end of this row, I think. You see, that's 10% already. Oh, maybe 1.5 rows actually. Oh, yeah, there's that weird bumpy bit. Yeah, I think I'll come around and I'll get that little row on the right hand side there, because it's not quite as big as this one by the looks of it. It's not quite as much stuff in it. Not quite as much straw. Now I've even cleared a space in my vehicle shed for where this is going to go. So I've got a bit of a plan about where I'm going to stick the hay loft, because it'll be easier to transfer it where I'm thinking. Okay, we'll erase that. Turn it off. Okay, cool. Yeah. So hopefully I can drive this in between here all right without crashing. Okay, yeah, good. I'll come forward a little bit. I kind of hate how the camera does that. Now it's left control I. Okay, we'll drive forward a bit so it's not all one stupid pile at the back. Cool. Now the next load we'll put it right next to that one, and then the next bay along, and then any we have left I think I'll just sell up at the hay barn up there. But cool, I'll continue duping around like this for a bit, eh? I'll get my fields harvested. I'll probably take all these down to the train. I could actually turn the engine off for the moment. I'll take them down to the train waiting for the prices to go up again, because that's rubbish, eh? It's bound to come up again. And we do have a lot of canola there too, but that's quite a, that's quite a low price for it, eh? So we'll sit on it for a while, because there's, how much have we got on the train? 24,000 worth. So yeah, we'll just leave it, eh? But cool, this dude's about halfway through. Cool, I'll bring you back soon. Okay, cool, welcome back. Yeah, I've got these two fields harvested. I've got that one there by the silo that's cultivated. That one over there is ploughed. I'm ploughing this one. Now I've been over to water the sheep because they were getting a bit low on water. I'll actually have to bring them hay or grass soon. Now I've moved all my crops into the train, but unfortunately the prices are still really low. So I've got soy and canola, that's going down again, so I think we'll leave that, we'll sit on it for a while. And soy, that's really low too, so we'll leave that too. I thought I might actually go and look for a job to get a set up for the next day. I'm not going to do a huge one. I might just do one of these little ones here. Oh. Maybe we'll do this one here. It'd be quite good to buy this field here too eventually, but we could do that long one there. That'll be quite a bit of money, that one. It's in quite a good place too. I bet we'll do this one. We'll try and lower the price if we do buy this one. So that's a fertilizing one. It's only going to be about $4,000. It's not really worth it, is it? Okay, we'll look for another one. Yeah, let's do this one. 9,000 or no? How much is this one? 367,000 to buy that. And it's only a $5,000 job. Maybe we'll actually leave the job, so I could do this one. That's a huge field, that'll take bloody ages. 34,000. 85 minutes though. So that'll take about an hour to do that one. Nah, bugger that. That's gonna take too long. I'll probably fall asleep doing that one. Maybe I'll actually leave doing a job today, or maybe just one of these little ones, just for the sake of it. See, that one's growing. We don't really are. That's a harvesting job on that field. How much is that field worth? 178,000? Yeah, I think I'll just do this one. Once again, I won't make you watch me do the whole field. I'll just do a little bit, and then I'll bring it back in once I finish. Oh, I'm getting a bit of graphical glitch there. Maybe that's some sort of haze from the exhaust or something, eh? At least I hope that's what it is. Okay, we need to unfold that. Yeah, unfold that. Go. What sort of crop is this? Oh, this is corn. Okay, cool. Yeah, this is one of the other fields I quite like to buy because it's quite close to the sheep and it's really close to the train station too, so it would be really convenient to like drop off crops like just over there for the train. But yeah, cool. I'll do this mission and I'll bring you back soon. Okay, cool. Welcome back about 20 odd minutes later. Just about finished this mission. We've got a tiny bit left on the pie up the top, so this will actually be really helpful. It's going to help us set up for the next day or two, or the next farming week or five, of what we can do with this. Oh, nice. Yep. That's pretty good payout. Now, how's that dude doing? He's about what, 2/3 through, I guess. Yeah, so I've got some exciting plans about what I'm going to do with the money. Now, I'm going to need to put some aside, but what I'll get, one of these sowing machines can do sunflower, soy, and corn. I'm not going to worry about sugar beets because we can't actually harvest them at the moment. That one's just potatoes. Get that one. Oh. It's 4.5 metres. That's 3 metres. We will be able to tow that one. Oh, we won't be able to tow that one. That's too big. That one there might be alright. So it's a little bit wider than the one we've got. See, it's 4.5 metres and this one's 3 metres. So it'll do our fields a little bit faster. And it does the ones we want. Now it's $90 a day though, but that'll do sunflowers, soy, and corn. Now the other three crops I really want to plant the next few cycles, because we'll need corn for our pigs, and I think sunflowers too, and they do give quite a good price too. They're not very high at the moment, the sunflowers, but corn is usually all right, eh? And soy's down again, but we'll also need one of these headers that does sunflowers and corn, because we can't just use this normal one because they're for the other crops, so we'll need to get one of those as well. So that's 12,000. How much is it with these as well, with this one? 12,041. Oh yeah, it's going to be a bit tight, isn't it? We might not quite have enough money to do both, but we'll at least keep the, should we, oh man, we might have to wait another crop cycle to buy that, unless the prices of these go up really high over the next day or two. See, canola's going down, wheat's going up, but we've actually sold all our wheat. We've got like 23 in our silo. Do we just buy the smaller one and wait longer to get our fields done? This one here, 3 meters. Ooh. This one's going to do it 50% faster, isn't it? Ooh. Faster anyway. does 50% more each row, so yeah, it's tough, eh? It's a tough choice. I think maybe we'll just get this cheap one. And then like later on we can upgrade to one of these bigger ones, eh, and do it faster. See, that one fertilizes as well. This one does too. I think, yeah, maybe we'll just get this one. Yeah, cool. Well, I'll pause it here while this dude's still doing his ploughing, and I'll bring you back in a little bit. Okay, cool. Welcome back. Back at the shop again. I'll finish ploughing that field. Now, what I'm going to do, since I won't need it for a while, is I'm gonna actually going to sell this baler, so I'm going to get 42,000 from it. So you will sell that. We'll keep the windrower. Oh, should we sell that too? We're not going to need that for a while either. Actually, yeah, I think we'll sell this too. Yeah, we'll keep the windrower and we'll keep that too because we'll be collecting grass and stuff later too. So 112,000. So we'll make sure we select the correct sowing machine, the one that can actually do what we want. Yep, sunflowers, soybeans, and corn. Yep, let's buy that. Now this tractor will be powerful enough to tow it. I'm a little bit worried about the weight on the front. It should be alright, eh? We'll see how we steer once we hook on. Oh, it's a little bit bigger than the other one. Oh yeah, sweet is, sweet is. This seems alright. So this should do in the space of our other machine that does two rows, so this will do three rows in the space of that one's two. So it should be a little, yeah, well, quite a bit faster, I think, eh? And of course, here, yeah, we have to fill it up with seed and fertilize it. We've still got two pallets left, I think, from when we started, so we'll just fill up the fertilizer there as best we can. Oh, you can cut me off. Yeah, here, we'll fill up a fertilizer there the best we can, then we'll use the tanks. Now, of course, we'll have to buy another header, but I'll wait until it's almost ready to harvest before I take the harvester down and, you know, get the new one, because otherwise we'll be paying the maintenance fee overnight, you see. So we'll get that tomorrow, what, probably, I don't know, about noon or something tomorrow. Although, yeah, we could wait until about probably an hour before these fields are ready to be harvested, because it's going to take probably an hour, I guess, or 45 minutes at least to sow these fields, and it takes 24 hours for each crop cycle, so we'll probably go get it about this time tomorrow, I guess, because it's going to take a little while to drive our harvester back too. Oh, can I shoot the gap between these two cars and try it? Sometimes they just keep driving and crashing into you, those dudes. Yeah, cool. Now that baling stuff that we sold, it's alright because like later on we can always buy other stuff or the same things to do that again, but at the moment the silage isn't really a high priority. I figured probably a cheaper way to do it would be to take a few like truck trailer loads over to the silage facility by the cows and just do a whole bunch at once. Load it back onto a trailer and then sell it at the biogas plant. Or, oh, you're gonna have to move that out of the way. Or our hay barn. Attach that. I'll detach that at least. So I think, yeah, I'll either do sunflower or corn this first time around. I might just do a whole bunch of. We'll have a look at the prices in a second, though. We'll see which one we think is going to go up enough to make it worthwhile. See, this one's still got a little bit of seed on it. Although, I guess if we do corn, we could stockpile some of that for eventually when we need pigs. I think we can stash it in the silo too. background here, and we'll see how much fertilizer we can fill out of this. So we've still got those two liquid ones here too, that we haven't even used. This will probably not take most. Oh yeah, it'll take all that pellet. I'm not sure how much that one's got left in it. Oh yeah, okay, yeah, it's full. Good. Alright, so we're going to fill up the seed. Then we'll have to think about what crop we're going to do. Let's have a look at the process while he's filling up. Now, corn's quite high, but that's bound to go down again soon. Wheat's going up. Sunflowers are going up too, so yeah, maybe all sunflowers. Get a good return. See, canola and soy are really low at the moment, so I don't think we'll worry about those for now. Yeah, we'll do sunflowers. So we've still got 82,000, right? It's going, yeah, maybe we should buy another tractor after the next harvest, eh? Speed this up a bit. Hire a worker. Oh, look here. Yeah, it spreads out a bit. Oh, so, ooh, that's a bit bloody fancy, isn't it? I've actually moved them over a bit. Nice. It's a pretty fancy machine, isn't it? So once again, I quite like all the little details in this. Look, it's got all the little stickers and all around here. All the little levers and buttons and springs and hoses and everything. Yeah, it's cool. And like, even in here too, I mean, like, look at all the level of detail in here. Like every little lever and button. All the little knobs and whistles. Isn't that cool? Yeah. Yeah, I quite like when a game goes to the trouble to put that much detail in it, you know? Well, it's probably not particularly necessary, but it's a nice touch. Yeah. Cool, well this dude, oh yeah, it's a little bit faster, isn't it? Cool, yeah, so I'll leave this guy sowing these fields. And I think I'll probably actually call this episode here. I'm not really sure how long it's been going. I've been zipping around a little bit. But when we come back, we'll be ready to go buy the harvester header that we need. So we need, remember, we need the special header to harvest the sunflowers and the corn. So we'll go and buy that. It's only 12,000 and that'll come in handy for a lot of things, eh? Or at least these two things. So yeah, cool. Bring you back next time, eh? Thanks for watching.